In this video, we are going to look at the differential diagnosis of a C8 radiculopathy and ulnar nerve entrapment as in cubital tunnel syndrome.
Enroll in our online course now. Link is in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. When assessing a patient with neurological symptoms in the upper limb, such as decreased sensation or diminished strength, one of your hypotheses is usually cervical radiculopathy. On our channel, you will find several videos that discuss the assessment of cervical radicular syndrome, such as the cluster of Ulnar or neurological assessment. However, in some instances, peripheral nerve entrapments should not be disregarded as a differential diagnosis, as they can mimic signs and symptoms of an affected cervical nerve root when a patient presents with neurological symptoms. Let's first look at the motor impairments in the two conditions. First of all, real atrophy is rare in radiculopathy unless it's long-lasting, as the C8 spinal nerve root is present in all peripheral nerve branches. Partial or incomplete weakness may be present in muscles that are innervated by, for example, the median nerve as well. This is important regarding the intrinsic hand muscles. The ulnar nerve supplies innervation to all but 5 intrinsic hand muscles: the abductor and flexor pollicis brevis, opponens pollicis, and the lateral 2 lumbricals are innervated by the median nerve, which runs through the carpal tunnel. So examination of motor function of these 5 muscles can help to identify whether the ulnar nerve is the culprit or not. Physical signs of weakness in ulnar nerve neuropathy are, for example, the Wartenberg sign. Here, the patient cannot actively adduct the little finger due to weakness in the third palmar interosseous muscle. Another popular finding in ulnar neuropathy is the Frohman sign. Here, the patient attempts to grip, for example, a piece of paper between the thumb and index finger. In ulnar neuropathy, the patient won't be able to grip it due to weakness of the adductor pollicis, or will compensate via the flexor pollicis longus, which is innervated by the median nerve. Let's now look at the sensory impairments. A C8 radiculopathy will involve sensory disturbance in the 4th and 5th finger, as well as the hypothenar aspect. Ulnar nerve neuropathy will have similar sensory loss, but the difference is that the radial or medial half of the ring finger is spared. If you didn't know yet, we have a playlist on cubital tunnel syndrome tests. Check it out on the left. If you want more videos like this, make sure to subscribe to our channel and leave a comment down below. Also, if you didn't know yet, we have an assessment ebook, mobile app, and online course that you can check out in the description right below the like button. This was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.